10 seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Radiant team ban. Radiant team ban.
Howdy there, folks! Welcome back! The Summit 4 continues now as we switch over to Europe. And of course, who better than Winter to bring us his amazing insight and analysis. Thank you. Also known as, Asian Merlini.
Sure, why not? You want to remind everyone about that again?
No, it's okay. So, VP of Artigia 4CL here, no. Winter, you go back.
Asian Mingli.
You go back maybe a month ago, VP would have been considered one of the strongest teams in Europe, like definitely top 2-3 at the most, and, well, haven't been performing all that well. So they come into this match against 4CL, who has had some crazy stand-up performances from Sexy Bambo. It is worth noting, as we're going to hop into the draft now, unfortunately, 4CL is missing one of their players who is having internet issues.
Yeah, captain, right? Soxa is the draft.
Soxa. Yes, I can never say his name right. But
he was the drafter of the team, but yeah.
So now we're going to have a Bambo draft. Huh. Full YOLO mode. Here we go.
I wonder who's this guy, though. I played with this guy in the pub. Okay. I remember his name.
Is he a fan of movie hook?
He's the fan of a punch hook. Dragon claw hook.
Okay. So nothing to do with Peter Pan here, then.
Probably not. But I think part of the reason of VP's, you know, underperformance in the last few maybe weeks, I think mostly it's because they haven't been really drafting towards what is like the best in the patch. They've been experimenting a lot, and I don't think they've been fully adapted. If you compare them to like maybe Secret or maybe other teams like EG is also adapting slower, but they have been adapting better than VP.
So the Spirit Breaker grab by VP here. They get a tanky beast that can go in for the big dives, but of course Ember, very tough to charge.
I think it's very similar reasoning why they pick Spirit Breaker against Nightstalker when I talk about Spirit Breaker versus Bounty Hunter.
Because you see him ganking, you just charge him.
Yeah, you just charge him when he's running around doing his stuff, placing walls so you can actually lock him down. And this time it's even easier because you don't need a dust for that guy.
And also nice versus Nightstalker because he's tanky. So not someone you're like, oh, Spirit Breaker, let me go gank him right now.
No, and you get his vision because when you're charging him. Now, because Trek doesn't give vision, this one gives the vision, the hero vision.
That's true.
So if he has the Aghanims, you actually have...
You have an Aghanim.
You have the Aghanims,
yeah. Although you don't get to choose where it goes.
Yeah, but it's...
Do we still have music on, Brian? I believe we still have music on.
5 seconds remaining.
K-Poptosis, still waking up here. Brian, why don't you brew us all a fresh pot of coffee once the draft is over? Because I need it as well. So. thank you, Brian.
You're welcome.
Guys, be sure to follow him at KPTDota, at What Is Hip TV, his alter ego, or at What Is Shit TV, if you were. But anyway, back to the draft. So
everyone is so savage in the morning.
Yeah, everyone's cranky in the morning, except for you. You got your beauty sleep. But yeah, VP, they'll ban out the Tusk as well as the Bane here. These strong initiating setup heroes can make things happen for Ember and Nightstalker. The Dazzle now, the pick from 4CL, who respectively banned all the physical, well, not all, but two very physical DPS heavy heroes in the Slardar as well as the Visage. Worth mentioning, VP is Direcide. They have their Queen of Pain, generally is the G hero. I think I've seen Illidan play it once or twice, so I guess if they wanted they could go into a TA for that Roche potential, but more likely it's the G Queen of Pain.
Probably, I think they have a higher chance of putting the Queen on mid, mostly, I think. They are not like, maybe I think the other team, the old Secret that likes to, or even sometimes S4, they put S4 on the safe lane Queen of Pain. I think VP doesn't do that so much. So I think it's more or less, you can say that the Queen is actually going to go mid. Because when you have, I think when you have SB, you want to put the Queen mid, because you're going to pressure the mid hero a lot. And then with the charge, you are opening a lot of opportunities for the SB to come in to gank the mid laner. So I think Queen plus SB is really good in the mid lane.
The fourth pick now for 4CL. They've got What looks like it could be two of their supports. In that case, they would need some cores. It's a Lina grab.
Huh. No one is...
Tough to say for sure.
They are ignoring the SF, though, on Radiant side. Like,
interesting.
Not something we see too much.
Most... Maybe saving it for a last pick here?
Saving it for last. Saving the best for last.
Against the Queen of Pain, and especially against G, who has... I mean, especially at TI, he had some really just impressive individual performances against a lot of the best mids in the world.
Yeah, and I remember during
maybe the, you don't want to play SF versus him.
During the panels as well, we were always talking about G would have a 20-0 or 22 game, but the team would lose the game. He would be on a roll with the queen, but his team would never win the game. That was like something we were talking about all the time. But this, with the Lina pickup, I think they are actually going to use Lina against the queen though. I don't think we'll see another mid hero. It's probably a mid Lina. Stalker could be offlane, could be support. But it's I think it's more likely that the Lina will be mid. You can obviously still play support, but I'm feeling the Lina pick is just to deal with the Queen in the lane. Because Lina can actually beat Queen of Pain in the lane.
VP do grab the Wyvern, third pick. Very difficult to set up that curse right now though, Winter. Still good for other reasons. We don't have like the big team fight combo.
It's still very useful against like all the physical damage from Ember, but yeah, like the curse could be difficult to use as a reliable disable against Ember, and they have Dazzle for, you know, dealing with the curse, you know, if you're trying to focus one guy down, because they are mostly now the SB and the Wyvern is all very single target focus, and Dazzle is very good at dealing with that.
Fourth pick for VP. What do they want? What is the plan for this draft, because I feel like we don't see a plan right now.
I think they want to keep, they get pick off and team fight because they have Wyvern and KOP. SB can also be a very good team fight hero. So I think something maybe Gyro would be like for Illidan, then they can actually play a very team fight composition so you don't allow the NS to actually roam and get picked off. Or maybe a Juggernaut, NS or Gyro or Juggernaut would be good. For,
no Illidan Dragon Knight, skip the nuke, just get the max. Dragon's blood build. Not gonna see his Dragonite anymore.
Failfish.
Ogre McGee.
Huh. So we've...
they were running out of time here as well. Down to 2 seconds reserve time when they made that grab. Generally, when we see Ogre picked, he's Silencer. A strong laning support. But
do they want Bloodlust Silencer? Serious?
But yeah, I mean, you more pick Ogre for the Bloodlust, generally. He's not, with the low range stun, he's not best initiator or ganker.
And you want him to obviously win your lanes because he's 7 armor.
Oh, trust me, this beefcake never loses his lanes.
Well, he does sometimes, he does, because he's still melee. A melee hero though, so there's a lot of things that he can't do in a lane. But overall, I think Ogre plus Spiritbreaker in the offlane could be, okay, bye Silencer, see you later.
No 4CL doing their homework, Winter doing his. This is why we bring you aboard, my friend.
It's very good versus
the walking Dota encyclopedia.
Come on, it's good versus the Dazzle and the Embers.
No, and it is something, they're one of the few teams that actually run that core silencer for Illidan, so definitely a good call there. Remaining.
So what else are they going to put Illidan on against these heroes? You don't want Slark versus Night Stalker.
Nobody's playing Slark.
Yeah,
right
no one playing Slark. Yeah, obviously. You
can't really get anything greedy like a Spectre.
I mean, you can go PR, but that's Ember. Like, Illusions are good versus Night Stalker. Like, Illusion-based heroes. Because Night Stalker is single target focus, but he might just be the support hero. So who knows? So I guess VP will decide after... Okay,
His
so
Majesty.
His Majesty will be...
Maybe you do want to PL now. Almost.
Wait. His Majesty is the safe lane. Night Stalker is support with the Dazzle. Actually, what?
Could it be a support Wraith King and Dazzle?
Yeah, Wraith King could be support, but I think Night Stalker is support with Dazzle, and
then Wraith King farming.
Yeah, Wraith King will be farming, but who's the offlane? I guess you put Lina offlane, or you ditch the Ember Spirit offlane. Like, what Secret do? For Secret, the offlane is the safe lane, so Envy is always there. 5 seconds.
I feel like it's more likely just like Night Stalker offlane, like Ember with maybe some help from Dazzle could go mid potentially. Oh, that was not expected. Wait.
A lot of physical damage. I mean, there's mixed physical damage from 4CL, though. Mixed physical and spell damage. But Lina at some point, because it's a mid Lina. Wait, maybe not.
Is it a mid Lina? I'm thinking it might be like an Ember mid. Bamboo, Dazzle supporting him.
Bamboo is actually picking 9S. So
offlane Night Stalker, safe lane Wraith King, support Lina and Dazzle. So Ember may need some help mid if G is having a good game.
Or the Lina could have a good game and farm the lags.
Can pull a Chuan and just AFK for 20 minutes.
Oh, it was even the, you remember the Vega game where Solo was like what, top 4 net worth with his Lina?
Oh my goodness, that game, he was balling out of control.
Yeah, I think the Lina as a support hero can have a lot of potential because it's easy for you to farm. Dragon Slave, you get creeps. It's just like Wyvern. Why Wyvern is so good? Because the Spinster Bus always allows you to get 100 gold because you get 2 creeps all the time. And it's long range, so you're always at a safe distance. That's why that hero always has farm.
Well,
maybe not when TPD is playing it because he doesn't take farm. But everyone else that plays it always has farm on the hero. When you're playing it like less of a position 6 hero, like you just buy the wards or everything. But that's only TPD, I guess.
Alright, Winter. Hook the stand-in. We'll be taking over the poor Ember Spirit, and it looks like might be headed mid with this early poor man shield, some pulled regen. Bambo, starting with the Mango, be laning most likely against Illidan's Huskar with boots first. That is not going to be fun for him. And then you'll have Pycat, EGM, and Niqua. They are checking the top burn. Do you think maybe they even go aggressive tri-lane and just put the Nightstalker bottom instead versus DK Phobos? Seems like it's not clear where they want to lane.
Possible, yet. Because Huskar's early lane. He's very good at zoning one hero, but not good versus three or more.
They will eat that ward and quickly retreat. Now Illidan engaging, but he's not that tanky early on. Illidan doesn't have to be careful, caught by the stun. Easy first blood for 4C&L. Now they want a second kill onto Lil Hardy. He's already committed. His Arctic Burn tries to run away. And no escape. Two heroes down, though. Stand-in gets a double to start the game and a bounty rune likely about to be grabbed. FNG will be zoned back by Dooney.
No, that was definitely not the play that
this is...
They ran up the ramp, like the high ground, even though they saw them, they have vision, but they just wanted to prevent. They were very greedy. They wanted to prevent the observer ward being removed.
I can tell you that G is not going to be happy with his team.
Nope.
His mid lane just basically got fed a bottle.
I can tell you that even though you have 7 armor here, but running up a ramp like that is not a good idea. Maybe they just felt that, oh, we have Ogre, we can actually take this fight. That's usually the case.
Oh, initial shadow strike on the creep. Fudgy, not sure if he was just trying to last hit or misclick, but Hook did not skill Sleight of Fist, so this would be a good time to harass him.
I think he knows, right? Because when they were fighting at the river, he used...
Yeah, I'm pretty sure it was just misclick. I did see... I'm trying to remember. I did see one Quap who potentially CS'd with
he was trying. Shadow he's still trying to fake it because he's level 2, so he never know if he has Sleight.
The nice thing though for Queen of Pain is the level 1 Sleight has a really long cooldown, 30 seconds.
Yeah, but the thing is, if you get one dodge, it's so worth it for the mana, like the mana to mana, like Shadow Strike is 110 mana.
It is expensive.
Mana. Yeah, 110 mana, and Sleight is what, 50 mana.
Especially when Ember already is bottle as well, you need all that harass.
Mm-hmm.
Well, not quite, but 100 gold.
So the tri-lane would definitely do, I think this tri-lane is actually going to be stronger. The tri-lane that 4CR have is stronger than VP's. After that, even before the exchange at the river, I still think that their tri-lane should be able to do good against this tree. So getting that kills in the river definitely even helps it do much better.
You are bottom, Bambo, gonna tank a charge here. Phobos wants to go for a little 17%. There is no mana for a void, although he could mango if things get really dicey.
He's really very unlucky there. That was what, 4 right clicks?
Yeah, that is definitely.
Okay, he gets it on the creep.
Let's reset that pseudo RNG and start from the bottom.
Yep. But I think in the laning phase, NS has, with the superior regen, should be able to do just fine. Unless the Spearbreaker gets really lucky with the bashes. Because you have really good armor on NS as well.
And you can always farm with your nuke as well, as long as you have some mana, so.
I think you try to use the nuke to actually just harass him out, like top lane.
Two hero. Stun from Niqua, though he's now in trouble as Huskar gets aggressive. There's the slow come out from FNG. This could be 2 kills potentially if they allow Illidan to continue auto-attacking. Niqua gonna go down, and now Pycat committed onto Illidan. May have gone in a bit too far. He's even diving deeper. Oh dear, Pycat. Where you going, buddy? Come back over here. Work, work. And we'll end up going down the club.
Okay.
Doing in his
now,
majesty.
Now the lane basically... You can even say that this lane is going to be lost already because the team who gets the later kills are always going to be much better, more worth it because it's more experience. So they have to be really careful in the lane now. Maybe you could say the lane is still even, but after giving those kills, it's going to be really tough and VP can pull. So I think the lane would kick back into VP's favor once they start pulling and getting more experience on the two supports here.
Well, very important for 4CL that they got those two kills early and the first blood, as otherwise Ember almost certainly loses this matchup pretty badly. And then you've got a Spearbreaker Nightstalker, which is at best
even. I'm quite surprised he's not even trying to go for his slide though. He's just going for chains and the shield just to be able to maybe harass the Kill Pain more. He's not even trying to dodge the poison, I guess.
And if the Nightstalker or somebody else rotates in, you can quite easily kill her.
Yeah, with this skill build, you can actually have more.
There's the chains though. G under his tower in a lot of trouble. Almost dead. Very close to getting the kill there.
Being aggressive, paying off there.
Yeah, that's the thing is, like, if Ember has an okay start, he's actually quite decent against Quap, but it's just those early levels where you normally get destroyed.
Yeah, I think maybe his thought process was because they actually got a good start, he got a kill.
That he doesn't need to die.
He got two kills, actually, and a bounty rune, so...
start is putting it mildly.
I'm not gonna dodge it, I'm just gonna try and kill you.
Oh, Ogre, he wants it. He wants that rune. Just out of range, unfortunately. Now it's nighttime, DK Phobos has the charge, but he will be forced to blow it to get away. And what do you know? Free haste turn. I'll leave that for my Queen of Pain. Now Vup. Be a kill opportunity if they want to make a move. And, well, by the way, FNG also was roaming. Looks like he planted down a ward up over in mid. Pop's gonna head back, though.
You know, I see...
Their cores are farming very well, Winter. Yeah,
I see teams, they sometimes prefer to run over here. This spot. And then they place it here.
Which one?
Yeah, in the mid lane. Spend an extra effort to actually run up the Ancients area to place it there. More effort, because it's harder to deward.
That one's a pretty good one. It's out of range of the normal deward spots.
Yeah, the only issue is you have to, you know, spend more time for that.
Sometimes people even smoke for that one. Yeah, this Ember's having a great start. DK Phobos.
Yep, because
forced
see,
to charge away
because
again.
See the NS is already starting to take control of the lane.
But
it's nighttime.
Oh, a haste to G arrives. Unfortunately, there is a lane ward. Ambo is gonna hang back, pretty much giving away that there's a lane ward, I imagine. But still, well worth it.
Yeah, it's worth the dodge. That is also gonna be a wasted haste. You know, the haste could have
wasted haste and a couple of waves of farm.
That
forever.
Haste could have been level 6 Queen of Pain TPing top, killing all the three heroes.
Yeah. Maybe jumping the gun a bit. He definitely had time with the haste turn. Didn't have to go right there.
I mean, it's a really big kill if he gets the kill on NS because SB is having a tough time in the lane and NS will be controlling the game in the second night phase. So if you shut him down,
he's charging
now,
mid, but a chains on this charge could really do him. And he's gonna cancel it.
Think if he goes in, he will die because he will chains him and use the shield, the flame guard to.
And then the charge won't even hit you if you time it light. But they are going on to Pycat. Illidan making the moves forward. Pycat low. There is a grave available. EGM just base tanking VP for the moment. Pycat healed up. EGM gonna have to grave himself. And Pycat low from the spears, but not dead yet. The TP out. He does make it back to the well. He barely survives. And now Ember rushes in onto Illidan. Should be able to finish him off. Hook. The big rotation. Grabbing a Huskar safe lane, this is really the dream start for an Ember.
So with
before the Night Stalker of Bambo gets active, he now looks towards mid.
With the dream start, do you go bots plus? That'll be interesting.
Maybe you stop off for something and then get your bots?
Aquila, drums, maybe. Yeah, that's what the players mostly go for.
It's gonna tank an initial Shadow Strike as Bambo inches forward, but now he's in vision of the ward, so...
Huh, he's saving a skill point on the NS. Maybe just for the ultimate if he needs it. He has one reserve skill point.
Yeah, I mean, generally you're not going to really need that second Hunter in the night unless you're going for a kill.
It depends though. A lot of players I see nowadays, even if support or offlane, they like to have a level 5, 3 Void and 2 Hunter in the night if you don't really need the silence against any hero.
I mean, I think you really want silence
because
this game.
You think about what the NS is doing, he has mana problems and he's running around placing wards and ganking. So the second point is actually very useful for him to do that.
I don't think he has mana problems at this point though. He's got Urn, Stick, Clarity.
If you're a support, obviously, then you have mana issues.
And it is a great game for the silence. Silencing Wyvern is huge. Of course, Queen of Pain is really good.
No, I'm not saying you don't get it. Like, you get it a little later.
Agreed.
Just for this phase, the first night phase, you want 2 points, so you're actually much stronger. So he's gonna use it on the ultimate.
And he manages to dodge the ward, but finally will be revealed. DK Phobos up on the high ground. I think he can really do much to Bambo on his own, though. In fact, three heroes from BP congregating. There will be a charge over towards the Ember, a bit slow on the chains, and that may cost him his life. The Queen of Pain ult comes and gets off the chains. Remnant's back. Just what could have been killing blow there.
Didn't have a random behind though.
That's unfortunate.
Almost died because of that. But
no nether strike there, I think, and just got level 6 now.
He's like half level 6.
I don't think he had it, because he looked like he had a moment to use it.
Okay,
but he did.
Maybe he didn't have it, I'm not sure. Wasn't paying attention to
I'm
that.
Pretty sure he did.
Yep, Bembo is getting charged.
Stick, he's also hasted, Phobos. Yeah, he reevaluates, decides to back off, and now Bambo, the great bait, is complete charge on cooldown. He's gonna rush in. Ember engages as well. Hook is in position. He's gonna make sure Lil Hardy runs the hell away. Get back, you stupid wyvern. I'm taking Phobos with me. And now they'll look for more. Void committed, earn charge online, and Lil Hardy gonna go down as well. Bambo doing Bambo things and just running roughshod all over VP. Four hits 5-2. It all feels like it really goes back to that double kill early, giving Hook the extra items and start he needs to survive in these fights to bait PN, and nothing's looking up for 4CL. Yeah.
I wonder if that was a bait in top lane.
Bambo? He's in pretty far.
He could have heal bomb maybe. That would have done a lot of damage.
Oh, then pretty low, but no rotation from Hook, who's currently being charged while they continue pursuit onto FNG. Pycat gonna need a crit here. Actually, there's one more stun.
He needs to stun Pycat.
There's the stun. He's gonna run, and Huskar's coming. This could go poorly for Pycat. Oh. He's level 6. He has not skilled the ultimate yet. Hanging onto it. He may need to. Skills it up.
Good
gets
trade.
The kill. Might even be able to go for Illidan. While that's going on, there's also an engagement break out amid Queen of Pain dies, but the trade will be the Ember going down. Pycat.
Oh, he does! He
committed the dunks there, and he's gonna get the kill, but still will go down.
Wow, that was really good play from the Huskar. I don't think he would have gotten the Wraith King if he didn't dodge the stun. He would have died there immediately, like one stun plus the right click. Because he dodged the stun, he was able to... I mean, he died in any way, but he was able to get something in return.
Yeah, the ult does make you spell immune, so... Well timed there.
I played Mr. Eden.
Very good against Silver Edge as well. Time it right. Armlet is up!
And this,
not the fastest armor, but a decent time.
Disarm as well, right? The Heaven's Halberd disarm. If they disarm you, you use your
attack. Yeah, your magic immune, so. It's like BKB.
Right now, it's daytime, so NS is not so happy right now. He's gonna wait for 11 minutes and 10 seconds, but then you pop your darkness. Because then it actually continues towards the second night phase, which is minute 12.
Are you saying the Bambo would have to wait, Winter? I don't know if wait is in Bambo's vocabulary. Yeah, that's definitely not. There's the stun. Now coming in, gets off the silence. The Void's there to follow it up. And one more auto attack. We'll secure
okay,
the
that's
kill.
A kill, so understand. Well, you don't wait for that. But if you can help it, usually you want to cast it before the night phase happens. So you get a really
so
long...
you have a yeah, so you don't have that annoying little period where it's back
yeah,
to
and,
daytime.
And you don't want darkness there, you know, you want to be able to keep using the spell.
Mm-hmm.
So, face boots earn, I think this is like, probably the best build for NS early game now. I think face boots is just much better than the treads. I feel like the hero just covers more ground, you know, when you have the face boots and you're able to... The attack speed doesn't seem so useful for me. I tried both of the builds and I feel like face boots just gives the NS much more in terms of ganking.
Well, especially later on the game as well, you're not really a damage dealer in most games. You're much more of a scout, so the mobility's nice.
Mm-hmm.
And also a lot of your damage comes from chasing and just casting Void
yeah, but
in the early to mid game.
Some people would argue that they would want to have the
extra
HP
is nice,
and the stats just to support your mana.
But you get a lot from eggs, which is the normal build. So I agree, I think Phase is a strong build, especially when you have other damage dealers. You've got a heavy damage dealing support Lina, you have the Ember who can dish out a lot, so you're less reliant on the Night Stalker to be
damage
a damage dealer with maximum attack.
Here we go, they know the Pycat ultimate is still down. They're gonna hunt him down.
Oh god, it's down for so long. That ultimate cooldown. They're chasing him. The creep's gonna lose vision though. His VP behind the tower. The rotation comes for mid. Hook. Moving forward. They're gonna find DK Phobos here. Got the charge ready though. They're kinda trying to wait for it. Chains are there. Interrupts the nether streak. Now he can charge out if he wants. He will initially charge onto 2G. Turns with the quad bolt. Just blows up the dazzle. And they still have the nether strike. Hook's got to be careful while that's going on. There's also an engagement on the Pycat trying to TP out. Looks like he's going to burn down in the well. And Hook also dropping low on the other side of the fight. Remnant 4G. One more auto attack. Won't get it off. The chains are cooling down. Hook's in danger. Needs this chains. He doesn't get it. That last second bash. Bam. He's dead. 3-1.
This guy's playing so aggressive. He didn't have a defensive damage.
And not even done yet. The Huskar also dies to Nequa, who didn't even commit a Laguna Blade. And barely charging away will be DK Phobos with 50 HP. And he'll survive as well.
And this Ember player is actually playing so aggressive. Like, usually you don't do that. You save a remnant behind. Like, he didn't save a remnant behind because he wanted to do the triple remnant burst.
He almost got a double kill out of it. He was just a bit short.
Yeah, but it was way so risky. And he went for the treads on Ember, so he didn't go for the...
Ambo hunting DK Phobos. Doesn't have mana for the combo, though. Actually, now he does.
Yes, it's a clarity.
Too late. Cow will get away. They know vampires like Cow.
Cows
figure they're more of the human type.
Cows provide a lot of blood. Didn't you watch Underworld?
No. Actually, no, I watched the first one.
Okay, maybe not cows, but he was draining a horse.
Okay, that's close enough. I accept that. You're gonna jump onto Death NG in the mid lane. The chains come out, trying to interrupt that cast animation, and one more poke from the Night Stalker's claws will secure the kill. 12 to 8 the score at 13 and a half minutes. Pretty bloody beginning to this game.
Yeah, both of their teams' lineup is just, they just want to keep fighting, keep running at you. Their lineup doesn't even take towers quickly, both of the teams' lineup. They don't really take towers quickly. They are both designed to kill and kill and kill, get map control, get vision. They have SB versus NS, so top lane, you're gonna dive again.
Do you even have to ask? This is Bambo we're talking about, Winter.
Okay, yeah, make sure I won't ask. So Bambo is going in again.
When is he going to dive again? We should have a Bambo dive counter. He actually hasn't even been that aggressive this game by Bambo standards.
I think people are always calling him diving, but he's very much of a player.
It's not stupid diving.
Yeah, control aggression now. Okay,
Bambo.
Maybe.
Well, that's the downside.
He's not diving, he just got caught.
That's hunting the enemy jungle. Kind of bad luck. Someone came from the woods, spotted him, and three were just campy mid. But still, in a way, it's the job of the Night Stalker, because now Pycat's free to farm top, your Ember was farming mid at least a little bit, and VP, they're five-manning their tower.
Yeah, sometimes when you die like this, it happens when you're playing Bounty, and as you're trying to give vision, you're trying to scout, you're trying to create opportunities to take advantage of for your team to actually go on them. But at the same time, when you're doing stuff like this, there's always a risk that you might be the hunted one instead of the hunter.
Oh, long-range weave comes out. Might discourage VP from this Roshan, and if they don't back...
Where is the Wraith
4CL
King?
4CL are ready to punish.
The Wraith King is still really far away.
He's rotating in, though, and Roche is not even close to dropping. Illidan even gets bashed in the pit with the armlet off.
They need to back off.
They are just asking for the jump in. Nukes flying out from Niko. The quad bolt connects onto EGM as well as Niko, almost instantly finishing both out, but he Lagunas down the Ogre Magi. May pay with his life, though. Ember jumping into the pit. Gets the stick off and Bambo arrives, focusing down Lil Hardy. They finish off the Huskar. Now they're going to execute DK Phobos unless he can charge away. He's got the charge. Interrupted by Pycat. Great patience there. And a 4 for 2. That was incredibly risky by VP.
I actually think they would have won the fight if everyone was at full HP. If they would have taken a straight up fight. What they could have done was run into the pit. Wait, don't hit the Roshan, because they know they have vision, they know they are coming. And then when they come, they just jump. I understand why they felt that they wanted to fight, because they have the Sonic Wave, so they are in actually a much stronger position.
It was only a level 1 Sonic Wave though,
yeah,
he just got level 2.
Yeah, still a lot of damage. Imagine if he fought at that position, he could have gotten it on multiple heroes. So
he got it on 2, but yeah, it wasn't enough.
You want to get it on 3 or 4, because they are running into the Rosh pit.
Yeah, Illidan was just too squishy in that fight. If he has full health, I agree.
I think they win.
Quite likely.
Yeah, I think they win the fight if he has full health there. It would have been close though, but they would have definitely.
Also, remember they were fighting when Weave had like almost fully set.
Yeah, that was another.
EGM Weaved pretty early. I think it was about to wear off when the fight began, and that makes a big difference.
Yeah, that was
especially for Huskar, who relies on his magic resistance. But if he's squishy to physical auto attacks,
yeah, that was an important point to note as well. The Weave making
good news for VP is they didn't actually do much damage to Rosh, so 4CL don't get to like steal it off that.
Good news,
still not
good. You make that sound like good news.
Better than the Moth stealing the Rosh, Winter. Come on, you gotta see the brighter side.
Yeah, so Ogre goes for the max blood loss.
He wants this tower, that's it. Meanwhile, mid lane, the fight breaks out. Illidan jumping in onto EGM Selfgrave. Not have a TP though, so he's in a lot of trouble. Hook getting caught, there's the two hero curse. Are they going to commit on this? Hook still has some remnants available. Slight of fisting through, and in the end, we'll bring down the Wyvern, possibly FNG as well. As the dunk comes out onto Niko, chain stunning down the Lina. They're also going to get Hook, just running at 4CL, courtesy of the Huskar. Bambo, late to the party. May cost them. Hook gonna buy back, recommits. Bambo joins the fight, and they end up getting 4 for 4, but they have to buy back on the Ember.
You know, the Huskar died to the Blade Mill. His burning spells was on Pycat, and he undertook.
Oh,
he died. Oh dear.
They still force out the Ember buyback. That's a... I guess on paper it's a slightly Radiant favored fight. Gold even experienced like 1,000.
Yeah, but they got more. Yeah, they got more experience. Obviously, they got more kills. So
does slow down the Ember's item progression though quite a bit.
Yeah, but you know, buying back and all this thing, like in a game like this, it doesn't really affect it because you're not really looking to get items later. You're looking to more.
Oh, they're looking to get items.
They're looking to.
They got double Midas.
I think they're looking to like control the game now. That's what more important. That's why they use their buyback, because they want to make sure that they win the early fights. Like this 5 heroes against that 5 heroes. I think whoever secures control in the early to mid game will just ultimately be able to snowball.
Well, they think they've done enough, because now they grab 2 Midases, one on the Wraith King, one on the Night Stalker.
Yeah, the Wraith King one is understandable, and the Night Stalker, because both heroes are heroes that farm very slowly if you don't have a farming item, and you need your levels. Like, Night Stalker wants his 16, Wraith King obviously wants his 16 as well. It's not the type of greedy Midas build, you know, that we usually
talk
about.
Well, yeah, it's not the good old NA Dota. Oh, triple yeah. Midas, Radiant, Battle Fury.
I can tell you it's definitely not Battle Fury on Doom. Level of greedy.
No, I don't think anything matches that. Impressively, 4CL have still held on to their tier 1 mid, despite the Huskar's constant aggression. Didn't even really damage the tower that much. Still 500 HP remaining, Glyph online. Bambo is lane. Being charged, top lane. They're gonna bring in G here. Like they even alone. Pop a smoke just to move a few feet forward.
He's alone. He's.
And maybe the charge is done. So, well, wasted smoke.
You know
there.
What actually saved him there? Because the creep wave was going behind and he was running behind to get the last hit. I mean, maybe he intentionally draw the creeps back, but... because he was last hitting at a safer position, so he was able to discourage Phobos from diving him in near the tier 2.
Yeah, they wanted to debut G's Orchid, but yet to see it have an impact on this game is... now go towards the bottom rune.
I mean, you really want to kill Hope on the Ember with your revealing Orchid, I think. That would be the biggest kill.
I'm curious to see the build here. Does Hook try to get away with a Battle Fury Rush?
Oh,
does
he go
towards the Manta? Yeah. Save his gold for now. Can't quite buy either of the components.
He's actually not that rich, though, considering the start.
Well, that's the buyback.
Oh yeah, that's the buyback. But even with the buyback, he's like, what, 60, 66, 67?
I mean, there's been like 5 heroes middle game. Look at the CS, actually. No one's farming except for G.
Yeah,
really.
Because of the lineup, no one cares about farming. They just want to fight and brawl and just make sure that they kill heroes.
Farm corpses.
Farm heroes.
Right, jumping on mid lane. They've gotten off a curse on the Bambo. Commitment here from the Huskar. Don't get in bashed for good measure. Pycat TP's in. A bit late to the party. Does have the blade mail, though. Illidan's respect that pops the blade mail, but it's while Illidan's backing off. Good kiting. Taking some damage. Nightstalker will... also rebuy and engage, but Illidan manages to get off the armless toggle. Pycat gonna go down soon with the ultimate. Queen to Pain finishes off Equa, courtesy of the ult, and still Hook trying to find his way into this fight. Sleight of Fist on cooldown. Pycat, the ult will pop, and only DK Phobos even slowed or affected by this at all. Now the stun, second round. Huskar waiting for his opportunity to jump back in.
Just look at how eager they are to fight. They just want to keep fighting.
Just fought back. He wants to die again, perhaps. The charge comes through. Connects on 2. Slam jam. And dive in deep. Illidan going for it. EGM unable to get anything done. G silenced him. Beautifully played there. Isolating and bringing down the Dazzle. Now Bambo almost caught out by G. Will be finished off courtesy of a Blink Scream. The aggression ramps up and BP. The dieback for Bambo. That's 2 additional kills and the tower. 4CL have been thoroughly punished for their insolence. 4,000 gold swing, 4,000 experience, and the Wraith King ult as well got popped there, so big, big win.
You wish you didn't have Midas for the fight.
They had double, yeah, that's where you wish you didn't have double Midas. And I feel like not enough teams do this. You see double Midas, like, yeah, yeah. Sure, maybe they're good heroes for Midas, you go fight them right away, yeah. not in 10 minutes.
You know what does the NA teams do when they see double Midas?
They buy 3 Midas. You know it's true.
They even got like a Vlad, so early Vlad on SB to try and keep fighting. So I think DP is clearly understanding the situation.
They found G, but it's for the Horde, perhaps. Laguna Blade will finish
them
off.
Charge.
But now they have no stun to interrupt,
you know? They're all weak. They have very low armor now. They have to be careful.
Niqua is going to drop. Tries to stun himself, TP out. Not going to happen. EGM definitely going out of that amount of fire spears. Will the creeps deny him? Ooh, sorry. 2 more kills. And a Roshan. VP are heating up.
They are more than heating up, they are in total control of this game right now. Yeah, they have to, like, 4CL have to rely on trying to buy time for their Midas to kick in.
Charge.
For the creeps, I guess.
Oh. Oh, they thought that was the real hero. They even commit the orchid to finish it off.
Our sexy friend is really long gone from that place.
Our sexy friend. Look at that mouth. That is not a sexy mouth, let me tell you. It doesn't even make sense.
Yeah, but he's very muscular. He's a strong man.
Do you have a thing
okay.
for Night Stalkers, Winter?
No. But I had a really good game with Night Stalker yesterday. Maybe four good games with
Night Stalker. Are you a Night Stalker picker?
I tried to play the hero. I'm not a Night Stalker picker.
You're a Night Stalker randomer?
No, I just wanted to understand the hero.
So then you are a picker.
Oh, whatever you want to call it. Picker is like you pick it 10 games in
No, I know. Just buff ups, buddy. Relax.
Relax, you're doing fine.
Well, 4CL,
I'm not doing
still
fine.
Doing fine as far as the gold goes, despite all those bad fights. Only down 3k, but
that's
VP, they're the team at the moment.
That's because of the Midas, though. That is because of the Midas. But if you look in terms of the bigger picture, they are losing out in map control. They are not going to be able to contest the next. So the lead will actually grow bigger because of what is happening now.
And G about actually just has completed a BKB. Spiritbreaker building towards one. There is no answer for a BKB charge here.
They're just gonna go high ground with this because it's daytime as well.
And they've got the Alpha Wolf as well.
Dude,
freshly tanky.
They need to get back. Rift King.
They want this tower force. 4CL getting a little greedy.
Wow.
Could be punished here. Illidan up on the high ground.
They're gonna lose their tier 3 tower if the Rift King's
for free. Wraith King finally will return, it looks like, but only after the bottom tower falls. In fact, the Dire even glyph for this. Radiant glyph already expended. Illidan losing a decent chunk of health. Still, the armlet, though, Sleight of Fist comes through. The weave gets magic as he drops lower and lower. Can they possibly burst him down? No. G jumps in deep behind enemy line. Then the curse comes through, and they're all turned against Nequa. The Lina almost dead. Quops will finish her off, and then gets off the ultimate, forcing back the Night Stalker. Not the best creative paint off, but good enough. It seems as Hulk continues to take a pounding, he's got to jump back to the well. G, BKB wearing off fairly soon, may need to retreat, but Husker's already done it. He's taking her axe. 4CL's greed has been thoroughly punished. They'll kill a Pygat once. Still at the Aegis, they can probably do it a second time. Round two, Pycat doing what he can here. They get the Aegis. And they stick around. VP, they don't want to give up their precious Huskar, and seems they won't have to. He even continues farming, working on the range tracks. Pycat reluctant to go in. Already, the Lina buyback committed just for this hold, and that's not even a hold.
Just look at their items on the Amber. They can't kill this Huskar twice. They don't have enough damage, and I have to say that the fight that they lost because they have Midas probably costed them. It's not only the greediness of Pycat.
Oh, Hawk! Big grab.
It's not that big though, it's just a support.
I always love seeing that.
Yeah, but even though Pycat...
No, it was big because it was a pretty sick play. Like, just randomly checking. Gets the chains timing right, but not big in terms of the game, obviously.
Yeah. But in terms of the game, I think even though if Pycat came back earlier, they would have still probably lost the fight, but he needed to be there, ready, you know. Because Dazzle was the one who got jumped on because they were trying so
to stall, yeah.
Yeah, to stall and just push out the wave, and the supports are the heroes that the Dazzle and the Lina were the heroes that has the spells to actually push out the wave, so they needed the Wraith King to be there to stand in front so they can't actually just dive the supports. But at the end of the day, I think in terms of the bigger picture, the Midas definitely felt like it actually cost them the fight in middle lane. I mean, I'm not saying if they don't have the Midas they would win for sure.
I mean, I feel like that's where if you evaluate the game and don't think you could take it, you do have the option of just split pushing. You have a Night Stalker and
yeah,
Ender.
Yeah, but then the heroes are designed to take fights. Yeah, heroes.
Yeah, but VP's also designed to take fights. And if you're going for the Midases, probably where you don't want to be
yeah,
fighting,
when,
right?
Oh yeah, I know. I understand.
Not easy to say at the time.
Yeah, when you get the Midas, you have to have the clear mindset that, okay guys,
let's
we
chill
are,
for a little
we
bit.
We are weaker this 10 minutes or 5 minutes. We need to chill and farm. Because it's not only one, they got two at the same time. So the captain has to probably realize that, guys, we just need to chill instead of trying to fight. But things were going...
Now
very...
remember, they're missing their captain here. Soxka is not playing.
Yeah.
Well, I believe he's the captain. We know he's the drafter.
So if Bambo is the captain here, guys, let's go fight.
I would love to play on a team with Bambo as a captain. I remember Pubby with him one time when he's Darkseer. He died like 10 times in the offlane, but there was 4 enemy heroes chasing him around, so everyone else just farmed We basically won by default. Fambo's a fun guy to pub with.
Fambo is the definition of space.
He really, that was the definition of space created. Now the ice armor on the Illidan. Siege will ramp up. He's up to 27 armor.
They should be able to push again. I think they don't even need to wait for... Do they want to wait for the next Aegis? They should be able to push though. I think they're strong enough. They have the Solar Crest on the Ogre as well. And obviously there's no MKB anywhere near. So the evasion is gonna be so
hard. This is when Huskar is like the Juggernaut.
Huh? The Huskar is the Juggernaut here? I think the Huskar...
Like the cartoon Juggernaut, not the Dota character.
Oh, the...
Have you seen that video?
No. I'm the Juggernaut, bitch!
Alright, fight breaks out. Quickly they delete Nequa, and now they engage onwards. Illidan fighting through the Blade Melba, trying to avoid hitting Pykeddy. BKBs, then gets healed up. The Wyvern also keep him alive. They've already killed off two, and Illidan still looking to man mode this one. Hook engages forward. Pykett, the ultimate committed now. Lina dead for 30 seconds. No buyback, but they will manage to carve up the Ogre. Rest of the team happy to retreat. G, BKB, and Orchid still available. But they did not want to commit into the fight.
They still won that fight handily. They dealt, what, 700 tower damage? Almost close to 700.
And they don't lose any big heroes there. Yep. That's good patience from VP.
That was enough for VP. They got.
They know the next Rosh is coming in 1 to 4 minutes.
Yeah, but at the same time, they're not willing to wait for the next Rosh because they want to pressure you. They don't want to let you farm. By doing that move, it might seem risky, but they're strong enough to do it. And as long as they do not overextend, they get enough damage, they get a good trade.
And that's the key. That's then, why they know Rosh is coming, so they get the kills, but then they back. We'll wait for the next opportunity.
That is the plan there, what they actually intended to do. They didn't just want to farm and wait. They wanted to wait, but pressure as well.
Have your cake and eat it too. It's the VP way of this game. They have an Assault Caress now, picked up on G. So we've seen a lot of out of S4's co-op as well, and with this, this is... just a very efficient item buildup for breaking the base winter. The Solar Crest, you already mentioned, great for that frontline tank, the Huskar. AC will help you take down buildings. They get the Frost Armor or Alpha Wolf, which also helps. Oh, DK Bobo is going in and is going to solo EGM in front of his friends. It's a terrible way to die, Lil. Looks like he'll be the trade, though. He did manage to spend some gold buying the makings of a Diffusal Blade. DK Phobos now being pursued out.
Oh, he put a TP there.
DK Phobos? No, he'll be okay elsewhere. Pycat, ultimate's back up. It is level 3 now. This is the benefit of the Midas. You get the quick level 3 ult. He dives forward. The Fire Spear stacking up. Pops the Blade Mail. Illidan turns and avoids the fight. G, trying to find his opening. BKB now committed. Jumping onto Bambo. That auto attack damage quite substantial. Doesn't... Oh, the Laguna though. Nequa, he's managed to complete an exit. It might just be enough to kill up G. Into the trees. Stole the Slave. Barely missing. Stops to farm the creeps. Getting ready to blink on back. Nequa missing the stun. G blinks out. And that last auto take, not enough, but the slave is! Nequa jams it in. That's a big kill. Ends a dominating streak for 1,000 gold. Wow.
But the Rift King still died, though. I think.
And they're not done yet. Illidan, yeah, I'm still in this game, guys. Not any longer.
What?
He's yellowed.
Where's his team? He's so far from his team. Where did he go?
Well, I can tell you, Wyvern died, and I think just came mid. And
so that was him running.
DK Phobos was just chilling like over here.
So that was just him running in.
That was a classic Illidan moment is what that was.
But he stopped doing that for a long time when FNG captained him.
It's the Huskar mindset, Winter. There's no running away. There's only one direction. That direction is forward. To the enemy fountain.
You know, one of the Huskar players I play with said this to me. The only time I'm backing when is when I'm dead. I'm back to the base.
He maybe wanted to go home. So he's like, alright, quickest way to the fountain is into the enemy fountain.
I don't know if that's actually the quickest way.
Still in pretty good.
I'm not agreeing to that being the quickest way. You know, a TP, by the way, takes 3 seconds.
I think his death took about 3 seconds, though, so I would say it's at equal at worst, you know? Double damage rune down in the river. DK Phobos will break a smoke. He's got a BKB here. You can just casually TP out. No basher. Oh, no way to stop this. And now the curse. They're fighting
into it.
Why
didn't he kill him? They could have killed him with Laguna. Yes, Aghanims.
Was he in range?
Yeah, he was. He was standing there.
Maybe, I guess, wants to reserve it.
For what?
I don't know.
The cooldown is...
I'm not Nequa. Are you Nequa?
Yeah, right. I'm Nequa. I'm Sexy Bambo.
Are you gonna roleplay as Sexy Bambo?
Bring some sexy back.
What do you make of the Diffusal Blade on Lil Hardy? Removes the Flame Guard, right? That only Yules. I think they both do, right?
He just wants to what, remove
the mana burn.
Yeah,
for
what
Wraith
else
King?
Does he want to remove? Like, he's not gonna be right clicking the Wraith King.
That was the only other.
Okay,
idea.
That's what I think. You know, maybe he wants Arctic Burn and mana burn for the Wraith King.
Yeah, all the burns. Oh, chicanes from Hook. Good initiation on Phobos. BKB is on cooldown, but the Wyvern keeps him alive in fighting shape. FNG also getting stunned during this time as G just slaughters EGM. Has the ult. That's a perfect setup for him. Laguna turn, but they can't finish up Illidan, and now 4CL in all kinds of trouble. The cow's back, and he's mad. He's diseased, and wants Piecat on the run. Okay. Ember barely surviving through this match to make it home to Piecat. Fourth hero down. Dunked in submission. That will be the Roche. And it may just be the game.
That would be the game itself. But if you are looking to remove the silence from NS or the Searing Chains, you kind of want to get used, right?
Mm-hmm.
I guess Diffusal is zero cooldown, so that's the only benefit.
Yeah, but there's also only one silence, so...
I don't know. Maybe. Maybe he really wants to be...
There's no Hex either.
Maybe he really wants to roleplay anti-mage here against Wraith King.
It could be that little extra bit of mana burn that makes the difference. Piecat, like, he's gonna cast at least one or two stuns.
Yeah, maybe.
You bloodlust the Wyvern. It's an interesting pickup, anyway.
I mean, it makes sense, but it's just... If you want to remove the silence or what the chains, you have better options.
Yeah. Radiant's bottom top. It's a luxury item, for sure. Very luxurious game for Lil. As he sits almost even with Bambo's Midas Nightstalker. 34 minutes. VP are cracking open this 4CL base. Working on the range tracks. Huskar, the big boy in front. BKB available if needed. He's also got the Sanj. Not quite. Oh, the curse coming out. We need to see where this Diffusal Blade gets used. Nothing cast just yet, but goes in with the auto attacks. 4C back Bambo. Illidan just destroying 4CL. The charges and now the bashes. Nether striking them back. G doesn't even have the ult. They don't need it.
He didn't.
They're going to start fighting under the shadow of
right
the...
Click. Right click the Wraith King. He's not right clicking.
He's supposed to use the Diffusal Blade, by the way. Come on, Lil. Do something! Lil doesn't really need it, but they have slightly overextended here. They'll lose the Illidan Aegis. Forcing out a buyback. Now he gets caught by a follow-up stun, but the Wyvern keeps him alive. They have secured the second lane of Rex. And Phobos comes trucking in through three heroes. Forced to jump back to the well. He's got the defensive remnant now for what good it'll do. As G engages onto Hulk Silence. Auto attacks and no bash required. Just regular ones will do. They also bring down Piecat again. CL. Dying over and over in the shadow of their own base will eventually give up the ghost. They call it GG. Well played. We're going to a game 2. VP, leading 1-0.
Question is every game going to be a brawl like this between VP versus 4 Clovers? It'll be pretty...
I can only hope. 36-29 yeah, score. That was a goddamn massacre.
Very exciting game if they actually choose to play like this. In the next game as well. And I don't even think that it's their playstyle is the issue. It's just they decided to take the fight with after you just purchased the double minus. It's either you do that or you decide to fight and you don't get the minus. Or you at least get only one minus. Maybe I think you get it on